Hi everybody, welcome to NuttX channel. Today I'll explain how to export an SD card like a USB mass storage. So let's get started. Open the Linux terminal, enter inside NuttX space NuttX, execute make disk clean to clear previous configuration. The support to USB mass storage and SD card use a lot of RAM memory and flash memory. So we need to unlock the hidden flash memory. Please watch this video explain how to do that. F100G minimum script. So change the flash size to 128 kilobytes. You need to verify if your board has the SD card initialization file, for example ls configs stm32f103 minimum / src stm32mmcsd.c. Also, you need to verify if your board has the USB mass storage support. ls configs STM32F103 minimum STM32 USB MSC.C. We need to configure to use our board. Tools configure.sh STM32F103 minimum / NSH. Now we need to execute make menu config to select the USB mass storage support. Make menu config. We need to select first the SD card support. Please watch this video explain how to do that. Okay, the SD card support is enabled. Now we need to reduce the RAM memory consumption. Please watch this video explain how to do that. I enable the SD card support and reduce the RAM memory consumption. Now I will explain how to enable the USB mass storage support. Enter inside system type, STM32 peripheral support, and enable the USB device. Exit. Exit again, enter inside device drivers, inside USB device driver support, and enable the USB mass storage class device. Enter inside it. We can reduce the stack size to 1 kilobyte. Exit. Exit again. And again. Go to board selection and select the enable USB device control. Exit. Go to application configuration. Go to system library and NSH add-on. Select the USB mass storage device command. Enter inside it. As you can see, the logic unit device path is already defined to SD card device file. So we can just exit again, and finally exit and save. Now execute make to compile the source code. The source code was compiled. Now we need to flash the firmware inside the board. If you don't know how to flash the firmware inside the board, please watch this video explain and execute OpenOCD. Ctrl R, OpenOCD, Ctrl L to move up. Okay, the firmware was flashed. I will show now a small trick to get the STM32F103 minimum board and the SD card module powered at the same time. What I did was to connect the 5V from the USB serial adapter to STM32F103 minimum board 5V pin. I did winding the wire and connect it to 5V and connect the VCC from the module to the same pin like this. So the USB serial adapter will power up the board and the USD and the SD card at the same time. And after you run the command, you plug the USB. Okay, I connected all the wires. Now I will plug the USB serial adapter and we'll execute minicon to run a command to start the USB mass storage in the board. Minicon. Let's check if the SD card device file was created. Okay, it is here. Also, let's check if the USB mass storage command is here. Okay, it is here. I need to run the mass storage connect command, msconn. Okay, it is connected. Now I need to plug the USB cable. Okay, let's see if the Linux detected it. The mask. Okay, it was detected, and also the Nautilus show it here. Okay, finally it opened. I open it and change the file content. This is a test from computer side. Save. I will eject the mass storage and I will run mass storage disconnect. Okay, it is disconnected. Now I will mount this SD card to see if the file was modified. Mount vfat / dev mmc sd0 / mnt ls mnt cat mnt test.txt. okay, the file was modified correctly from PC side. And basically that is it. I hope you had enjoyed this video and see you in the next video. Bye bye.